The Jamaica Civil Service Association says there is no indication there will be job cuts in coming months. President of the association, O'Neill Grant, believes this will be contemplated in a worst-case scenario.
I think what the Prime Minister was doing was actually lining up all the possible scenarios that have to be taken into consideration if the economy, we're not able to restart in, say, 6 months. We take that in stride. We recognize it is one of the what-ifs that has to be looked at seriously and planned for. I'm sure that the recovery team that the minister is chairing is going to take that into active consideration to ensure that these are properly measured and factored into any decision making that is going to take place in the not too distant future. For the Jamaica Civil Service Association, we have received tacit assurance that there is no likelihood of any cuts in the public sector in the next month or two. What happens in July is something that we will have to look back at again to determine whether or not the economy is now on a path of greater back to some normalcy.
And Mr. Grant supports the plan to kickstart the economy. However, he cautioned that this must be done in a controlled way to prevent a surge in cases of the coronavirus.
There are some opportunities that we can look at in terms of opening the economy. And if we get those right, if we nail those down, I think we are going to be in a better position to reopen. But it has to be a measured, considered, deliberate, and watchful reopening. The dashboard has to be looked at where we see danger on the horizon. We should be able to scale back. When we see things that are looking good, we should be able to relax certain things. But it can't be just a free opening of everything. This issue of social distancing and wearing of masks and just basically operating in an environment that there's an active contagious virus is something that we're going to have to do. I don't think we have much choice economically to keep ourselves in this position. If we do so, we're likely to suffer significantly.
Stevie Ann Winter, Frontline News.